I remember when I lost my mind. There was something so pleasant about that place. Even your emotions have an echo in so much space.
So, it looks like she's had quite a busy night. Mirabelle has been admitted after the police determined that she was a danger to herself. While in custody, there was an attempted suicide due to an overdose of narcotics. According to the police, she'd already consumed a considerable amount of alcohol. Police were called due to a disturbance caused by the patient. It seems she's managed to find her way into the flat of a former partner.
Married?
Police say that she then poured vodka onto his clothes and tried to set them on fire with a match. Once that's failed, there was an altercation with the man inside and she was forced outside. Mirabella's then proceeded to bang violently on the door and caused the disturbance, which has obviously brought the police. Police have arrived to an incoherent and hysterical individual who demanded that her property was inside the flat. The police have escorted her back into the flat. Try and retrieve her property, and it turned out it was a goldfish in a goldfish bowl. Once they were outside the flat, our patient Mirabelle has flung the bowl and the goldfish at our victim, hitting him in the head and screaming, "Why don't you go F your fish? You're both cold-blooded."
Any history of violence from the partner?
Obviously, the police have found that amusing.
When I was out there without a care, I was out of touch. And it wasn't because I didn't know enough. Just knew too much.
Any history of violence from the partner or patient? Maybe self-harm issues? Previous suicide? Bipolar?
No history of violence, no. However, the police report does state that they received a lot of complaints that night of a woman who screamed uncontrollably and was acting violently. The patient was recently dismissed from her job, so no relevant paperwork to do there. That's lucky. And she's told police that her dog had recently been run over.
So, breakup, loss of a loved one, and loss of a job.
Life always delivers in threes.
For a sleeping disorder. Tell you what, let's get her on a tricyclic and try to bring that volume down.
I don't want to turn the volume down! I want my dog back.
Well, I hope that you but think twice.
prescribe something for you. Get you to relax and sleep. It'll take the edge off. Then you can tell me a little about what happened.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. It's just so unfair. Why is it so unfair? Why did Oscar have to die?
Was Oscar your dog?
Mirabelle, I'm Heather. I'm your occupational therapist and I'll be around later to see how you're doing. And every day we go for walks around the garden, if you'd like to come.
I lost my job. I'm gonna have to find a job.
No, you don't have to think about that just now. You just need to rest.
Okay. Yes. Sleep.
Why we're so eager. It'll be the same substandard garbage it was yesterday. Beat staring at a blank television though, eh?
Eh?
Oh, come on. Lunch already.
I don't blame you, you know.
Right. Well, that's a good thing. I just want them to give me my phone back. Because this is bullshit.
Nobody said it was gonna be easy.
Where's the water? You just can't get good water in this place anymore. What a bore. Good morning, Rochelle, Gladys, hi. Would you be so kind as to look into the water situation? We're all out. Thank you. Lunchtime. It's my favourite season. If I'm not listening for those squeaky wheels, I'm listening for that bell. It's all so dreamy.
Ah, about time.
Now, Mrs. Groucho, the girls do the best they can.
Hello, Jordan. How are you today?
Fine. When am I allowed to see the doctor? I want to change my drugs.
I'm sure the doctor will see you soon enough. But right now, he's very happy with the progress you're making.
God, don't ever quit your day job. You're a terrible actress.
What's on the menu today, Rochelle?
Well, Gregory, you're in luck. It's your favourite. It's our homegrown pea and asparagus soup with mashed potatoes and a side of boiled cabbage and Brussels sprouts.
A newbie!
I've been asleep.
Huh? That's a great title for a doco. I might pitch that to my producers at TV3.
Be careful. She's famous, which simply means she's been on television.
Oh, I'm serious. Someone should make a doco of this place.
Hi.
Hi.
You can have my pudding if you want. We could swap bowls and they wouldn't notice.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh shit! Oh god! Oh no! What have I done?
No. We don't share our food. We eat our food. Billy has his own food, and this is yours. If you don't want your pudding, I'll take it away.
Thank you, poor Gladys.
Thanks.
They're a bit harsh, aren't they?
I'm Zoe. Thanks for helping me. They usually force feed me and make me take their drugs, so thanks for understanding.
Hi, I'm Gregory, your resident donkey. How we do love a newbie. You can solve all our problems, and we have quite a few.
Well, don't listen to them, they're nuts. Do you want to come outside with me for a cigarette? I've got clearance, I could sneak you out.
Hey, I'd like to tell you a secret.
You could probably stand a break from this place. I mean, you look so normal.
So exciting. A new friend. Please love me.
I so need someone sane to talk to.
You're the only one who listens to me.
I wanna be your vacuum cleaner, breathing in your dust. I wanna be your Ford Cortina, and I won't ever rust.
If you like a coffee hot, well, let me be your coffee pot. You call the shots, babe, I just wanna be yours.
I wanna be yours, I wanna be yours.
I wanna be yours. I wanna be yours. I wanna be yours.
Let me be your lucky meter, and I'll never run out.
And let me be the portable heater.
Set in lotion.
Wanna be.
Hold your hair in deep devotion.
How deep?
At least as deep as the Pacific Ocean. I wanna be yours.
Secrets I have held in my heart
are harder to hide than I thought.
Maybe I just wanna be yours. I wanna be yours. I wanna be yours.
Yours, wanna be yours.
Hello, Billy.
Shh.
What are you making?
You need to be very quiet. They are just about to sing. They are very nervous. I hate it when they get nervous. It makes me nervous too. I'm always worried about Silas. He's the shy one. He can hardly speak, but he loves the group. He only sings inside the group. Silas would never sing outside the group.
Where do you find them all?
Oh, I don't find them. They find me. I know that it must be very difficult to find me, and so they must really want to be here. For some of them, this is real therapy. They have nowhere else to go. So it is like their little family.
So, do they all have names?
This one is Beatrice. She's the bossy one. Beatrice likes things just so. I try to keep her clean, because I know she would not like to be in the toilet. Beatrice does not like the toilet.
Okay.
She is my soprano. And sometimes she gets a bit screechy, but she is a true leader, and she always knows her part. Benny. Benny, Benny, Benny. Oh, it's okay, Benny, don't be frightened. Benny is my protege. He has the most beautiful voice, but all the others are jealous of him. This one is Alexis, and she looks after everybody. She is my alto, but she can sing tenor too, you know, for the times when Silas is too quiet. This one is Carole, and this one is Julia. They are twins. You don't get that too often. Twins! Oh. I'm hungry now. Hungry and thirsty. I'm hungry and thirsty.
Would you like some water?
I'm very hungry and very thirsty. Okay, I need to be ready. They will get angry if they do not have my full attention.
Are they singing now?
Obviously not, no. Shh, please. You cannot speak once the concert has started.
Now that we found love, what are we gonna do with it? Now that we found love, what are we gonna do?
music playing. Hey, I wanna see you dance, dance, dance. Come on, baby, see when this music's playing. Come on, wanna see you dance. Get up and dance, music. Oh yeah, yeah. I wanna show you what a making, what a making do, yeah.
Now that we found love, what are we gonna do?
Fun.
Of course, and they like you too. Okay, guys, that was really good, but Benny, you just need to remember to give some of the solos to the others next time, okay? Will I see you again?
Yes, I can stop by tomorrow. Maybe we could do some crafts, maybe with your pine cones.
Maybe they would not like to do crafts. They need to practice.
Okay. See you.